Hi, Paul Zammit of the Toronto Botanical Garden here, taking advantage of this fabulous fall weather and working on getting some of our bulbs into the ground. That is our fall planted bulbs for spring display. And we've got thousands to get in the ground. I'm digging a very large pit here where Sandra and our volunteers will get them into the ground. But I want to show you a trick that I like to do. If you don't have this vast space, how do you get them into your perennial border, etc.? So one space I often recommend is in between your ornamental grasses. Now right now, ornamental grasses will have a big flow to them, a big skirt if you will. So what you can do, you can see I've tied the millennia up top. I've also started to tie it down below. Now I need to find my string, there it is, and pull that. But what I'm doing is just really tying it up to give it a much narrower footprint. And I will be using the space in between, all of the space in between here, to be able to plant more bulbs. And the advantage to that in the spring is many of the ornamental grasses are very slow to emerge. So in the space around them, you have that pop of color. And then as the foliage of the ornamental grasses comes up, you help to disguise that dying foliage. And please keep in mind, that dying foliage on your bulbs is very important because that builds up the nutrients to give them the show next year. Other tip, when you're working around ornamental grasses, wear the gloves, wear the long sleeves. They tend to be a bit sharp. And as you can see, I'm stepping on boards. The ground is often very wet in the fall, and if you've got a clay-based or heavy loam soil, if you're stepping on that, you do cause a lot of compaction, which is an idea. So I got lots of bulbs to get, sharing with you some of my tips from the Toronto Botanical Garden.